Alright, ladies and gents, how you guys doing? In this video, I'm going to do some speed test, boot up test, and then I'm going to do some in-depth video test, importing, how it works in iMovie, how smooth it is, and then finally an export test. Of course, this is the new MacBook Air 13-inch 2011, the one that is priced at £1,099. It's the low-end 13-inch, no customization or anything like that. Specs of both of these machines are appearing. So the first test is really quite simple. I'm going to switch both of these machines on at the same time. So 1, 2, and 3. Let's see which one. This one came on first, the white screen came on first. And I can't really make out which Apple logo turned up first, but nevertheless, let's see. We shall find out soon which one won. This one is booting up faster. And boom, we're into line. And that one has just came in. Guys, let's move on to the second test, and it's basically loading up iMovie. So moving on, let's open up iMovie 11 at the same time to see which one opened up faster. Boom. And yeah, this one is a tiny bit faster, as you can probably tell. And we shall skip this. And now let's import a file, mess around with it and see, you know, how it acts up. For this next test, it's really quite simple what we're going to do. Import two of the same files in original size, full, and let's see which one does it faster. This one, less than a minute. This one, less than a minute as well, but this one is going much faster. Let me zoom in and show you so you can have an idea. There we go. Less than a minute. Let's pan over to the old MacBook Air. This is just before half time. This one is, you know, almost there. Let's switch back to the old one, halfway now. Let's switch back to the new one, it's done. And it's saving into the project. And bam. The new one has done it faster, imported faster. And that is obviously because of the faster processors. The dual core i5 does help. Both of these systems have 4 gigs of RAM. The graphics card in both of these are kind of different. Intel HD 3000, and this one is the NVIDIA 320M. And hey, what do we have here? The old MacBook Air has imported it as well. Okay, so now just to kind of zoom in and show you on the new MacBook Air, let's select this entire clip and paste it up here and kind of just go through it. And this, you know, it's quite smooth. It's not, you know, lagging. Not that it lagged in the old one either. This seems to be fine. It's smooth. Let's put the volume down. That might help. But you know, it's fairly boom bam in your face. It's not hanging. And there we go. Just, you know, giving you an idea. For those of you thinking of possibly getting this one or the old one, and let's try and do that the same thing with the older MacBook Air, just to be a bit fair. So there you go. So there you go, we've got this project running in the old MacBook Air as well, and it's, you know, fairly smooth and moving it about. It is lagging just a slight bit, you know, just a tiny bit of difference I can tell coming over from the new MacBook Air, but nothing major or oh my gods, or it's, you know, it's smooth as a baby's bottom, as they say. There we go, just, you know, dragging it along. I've just changed the format in this iMovie, so that's why the project is below rather than, you know, above. I like this layout better, and hence why I've got it. But yeah, I can notice a tiny difference between two of these. Nothing, you know, large or huge. And last but not least, guys, what I'm going to do is export both of these files in HD 1080. And let's go. And again, the point is just to see which one is faster. So we've got about 2 minutes on here, or going up to about 3 minutes now. And that one is about 5 to 6 minutes. So there's roughly, the speed difference is probably about twice. And that's going up to 7 minutes. This is about 4 minutes. I think it's more of an accurate time now. So just to be record on the record, 4 minutes and 7 minutes. This is going up to 8 minutes now and dropped back to 7. So here we go, about 3 minutes on the new MacBook Air. Let's pan over to the old MacBook Air. About 6 minutes. 5 minutes now, 6 minutes again. Make your mind up. So about 6 minutes, let's pan over to this new one. about 3 minutes. So there's, you know, more than 50% difference, or twice the difference, shall I say, between these two machines. Guys, I hope this video has been useful. If you've purchased any of these and done tests yourself, you know, feel free to leave a video response or a comment below. Has this video been useful? You know, let me know what you want to see, and I will, you know, do my best to try and get those videos out for you. Stay tuned, because I've got tons of other videos coming up. If you haven't seen the previous MacBook Air 2011 videos, click on the screen on the annotation to take you to that part. But guys, if you haven't seen the previous videos on the MacBook Air 2011, or you want to stay tuned to the series, click the subscribe button, or you can click on the annotation to take you to the playlist. Just before I sign off, 2 minutes and 4 minutes, and just to kind of show you, 2 minutes on the new MacBook Air and 4 minutes on the old MacBook Air 13-inch 2010. Guys, I would appreciate if you can check out my new venture, iGear.com. And guys, I will see you guys in another life. Cheers!